Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss Provident Funds. Meaning of Provident Fund. In order to promote savings for social security of employees, the government has set up various kinds of Provident Funds. The word Provident means to provide for the future. A fixed percentage of salary is contributed by employees every month towards the funds, and in many cases, employer also contributes. When these contributions are invested to earn interest, and same is credited to Provident Fund of the employee. At the time of retirement, employee receives this amount along with interest as lump sum. If unfortunately the employee lost his or her life during the service, then this lump sum amount of fund along with interest is received by legal heirs. This amount is greatly helpful to them. Types of Provident Funds. There are four types of Provident Funds, namely Statutory Provident Fund, Recognized Provident Fund, Unrecognized Provident Fund, Public Provident Fund. Let's discuss Statutory Provident Fund. This fund is one of the oldest funds which was started through a Provident Fund Act 1925. In order to promote the savings among government employees, this fund was established by the government or semi-government departments like Railways, Reserve Bank of India, universities, colleges, local bodies, statutory corporations, insurance companies, and nationalized banks, etc. Employers' contribution towards the employee's statutory provident fund and the amount of interest earned on the accumulated balance to the employee's credit balance are not to be included in the employee's income. When the employee retires or left the service, whatever accumulated amount under this employee receives shall be exempted under Section 10, Subsection 11, and this will not be a part of total income. Second is Recognized Provident Fund. This is very important from numerical point of view. This fund is recognized by Commissioner of Income Tax. It comes under Provident Fund Act 1952. This fund is generally maintained by scheduled banks, industrial undertakings, business houses, factories, etc. Treatment of this fund is, if employer's contribution is up to 12% of employee's salary, this will be exempted, that is not included in the salary of employee. But if the employer's contribution is over and above 12% of employee's salary, then it will be included in the employee's salary and it is taxable. If employees contribute towards this fund, then it will qualify for deduction under Section 80C. Treatment of interest on this provident fund. Interest on credit balance of this provident fund, if the interest is up to 9.5%, it is exempted. But if this interest is over and above 9.5%, then the excess will be taxable, as this will be deemed to be employee's salary income and be a part of salary for that previous year. Third one is Unrecognized Provident Fund. This fund is not recognized by Commissioner of Income Tax, but approved by Provident Fund Commissioner. Both employee and employer contributes towards this fund. This fund is maintained by private sector organizations. Employee's contribution is added in his or her salary if net salary or salary after deduction is given. An employee will not be allowed any deduction under Section 80C while computing the total income of that employee. Employer's contribution and interest on accumulated credit balance of the fund are not to be included in employee's salary from year to year. Payment received out of this fund is taxable to the extent of employer's contribution and interest thereon. The employees are entitled for relief under Section 89, Subsection 1. Employees' contribution is ignored as it was taxed when it was contributed, but the interest on employees' own contribution shall be taxable under the head income from other sources, not under income from salary. The last one is Public Provident Fund. On July 1, 1968, a new fund known as Public Provident Fund scheme was started. Every individual, whether salaried employee or self-employed, can subscribe and take the benefit of reduction under Section 80C. Self-employed individuals are doctors, accountants, actors, actresses, lawyers, traders, pensioners. This fund is simple and suits everyone. The individual can open an account in State Bank of India and its subsidiaries, or at branches of nationalized banks authorized for the purpose by the central government. The subscription or payment to be made in this account can be between the denomination of Rs. 500 to Rs. 150,000 in one financial year. One can deposit money in installments which cannot exceed 12 installments in a year. The PPF account can be opened in the name of individual or on the behalf of a minor of whom he or she is the guardian. But individual can open only one account in his or her own name. Withdrawal procedure of PPF. Partial withdrawal after the end of 6th financial year from the opening of PPF account, a subscriber may be allowed to withdraw as per the rules. Not more than one withdrawal is permissible during any 1 year, so partial withdrawal and loan facility is possible under PPF. Full withdrawal is possible after 15 years, but in case of death of a subscriber, full repayment shall be made to either the nominee or legal heirs. Tax treatment. The subscription towards this type of fund is eligible for deduction under Section 80C. Interest credited in this account is fully exempted. The entire amount received from this fund, including interest, is totally exempt from income tax. That's all. Thank you very much. Subscribe my channel and like this video. पढ़िए और आगे बढ़िए. थैंक यू.